Welcome to the Galaxy Note 10 Lite review. It is coming out late and that is because I was busy testing this phone thoroughly. Before we begin, make sure to subscribe, press the bell icon and thumbs up if you like this video at some point. In the box of the Note 10 Lite, you get a lid with some paperwork, a TPU case and a SIM eject tool. You also get a 25W superfast charger, USB Type-C cable, a headphone and some S Pen tips. Samsung offers a Note 10 Lite in the Aura Red, Aura Blue and the Aura Glow colors, which also happens to be the color of our today's device. Price of the Note 10 Lite will be on your screen. Talking about the design, first of all, Note 10 Lite follows the design language of the new Galaxy S and the A lineup smartphones. This is a big phone and hence has a lot of bulk to it. Weighing over 200 grams, the Note 10 Lite has got feels and characteristics of a flagship. Had it not been for the plastic build of this phone, I wouldn't have hesitated to call it a flagship device. Note 10 Lite is completely built out of plastic with aluminium frames surrounding it. The phone's back is curvy while it has a flat display profile. A camera cutout going towards the top left side of the phone's rear is holding three cameras. At the bottom is the phone's headphone jack, a speaker, a mic and the S Pen slot. The volume rocker is on the right side. At the top is a secondary noise cancellation mic, SIM card slot is on the left side and it is a hybrid slot, which means you can put in two SIM cards or one card and one SIM card at the same time. Note 10 Lite is using Samsung Super AMOLED screen. It is a 1080p into 2400 pixels display with a PPI of 394. Aspect ratio is 20:9 thanks to the tiny punch hole on the front. Display quality is unquestionable. For the most part, it's the same screen you find on the high-end Galaxy A phones and also on the new Samsung Galaxy S10 Lite. Super AMOLED displays are always accurate with the colors and the brightness. The viewing angles are perfect. No matter what angle you are looking at the phone from, the display will remain visible. Watching videos outdoor was a great experience for me. You will not face any difficulties with that. Indoor, the display is just superb. Screen is probably that one thing that Samsung can never go wrong with when it comes to its phones in the mid-range and the sub-flagship category. The display also has a fingerprint scanner underneath. Bezels of this screen are very thin. The bottom chin is equally thin too. In my use of over 1 month, I thoroughly enjoyed the screen of the Note 10 Lite, and then using the S Pen on this smooth screen is an experience which is one of its own kind. You do get the choice to change the display colors. You may use the dark mode, which will also save you a little bit of battery on a Super AMOLED panel. As far as the performance of this phone is concerned, this is where I am a little bit disappointed. The phone at first uses the Exynos 9810 CPU. This is the same CPU we saw on the Samsung Galaxy Note 9. It means we are using a processor from the year 2018. This phone has a score of over 330k on the AnTuTu benchmark. We get an 8GB RAM coupled with a 1 to 8GB internal storage chip. Storage is not a problem as you can definitely expand it up to 512GB using a microSD card. I played the PUBG Mobile on this phone and tested its frame rates with smooth extreme settings. Hitting 60 frames per second was not a problem for this phone. It was quite sweet with the PUBG Mobile, but what wasn't really good was the temperature. Some parts of the phone hit over 40 degrees and that is not good. I know 40 degrees is not extreme, but if you play this game for a similar time period with similar settings on a Snapdragon 855 CPU, it will not cross 40 degrees. Speaker is just an average one. There is only one bottom firing speaker. We don't get stereo speakers on this one. Check out the sound quality for yourself. Since this phone happens to have a headphone jack in the year 2020, I suggest using that while you are still blessed with it. Use it with the Dolby Atmos turned on. Moving on to the software. Note 10 Lite is powered by the Android 10 themed by Samsung's One UI 2. It is sad that we did not get this phone with the One UI 2.1 while it was available at the time of this phone's release, but I do hope we will get that soon. Now this phone has got all the basic features of the Samsung One UI 2 like the dark mode, the screen recorder, the smart sharing features, navigation gestures, one-handed mode and everything else you get on a real flagship from Samsung. We do get the S Pen, but do not expect the features like Galaxy Note 10's S Pen from this phone. This S Pen is similar to what you get on the Samsung Galaxy Note 9 with very limited Bluetooth control features. You do get the Air gestures and some other nice features like the live messages and stuff, but it doesn't have advanced control we saw on the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus. This S Pen is the only thing that Samsung is charging you that whopping amount for, and you can decide if it is worth the money or not. The S Pen might attract artists or the creative people for the most part. A Note 10 Lite has three cameras at the back. The main sensor is a Sony IMX 333 sensor. It's got a 12 megapixels ultra-wide and a 12 megapixels telephoto lens. The main camera is the same that we saw on the Samsung Galaxy S8 back in the year 2017. On the front, the Note 10 Lite has a single 32 megapixel Sony IMX 616 sensor. With the image processing of the Exynos 9810, the Note 10 Lite takes warmer pictures by default. We do not have the pixel binning camera to take huge pictures here, so you will not get as high details as you get from a 48 or a 64 megapixels camera. But the details as far as this phone goes will turn out fine. The pictures look very good, as if you have captured them from a flagship camera regardless of how old it is. The front camera is very good, it's a new sensor and it does its job perfectly. It captures impressive selfies and the live focus mode works equally good. The rear camera can capture 4K at 60 frames per second and 1080p at 60 frames per second videos, while the front camera can do 1080p at 60 frames per second videos too. It can capture 4K in the wide and ultra wide modes too, and the super steady video mode is also there. Note 10 Lite is equipped with dual OIS, so you don't have to worry about the stability of your videos. Samsung has rolled out a new software update to further improve the camera performance of the Galaxy Note 10 Lite, and I am sure that things are getting better now. Inside the Note 10 Lite is a massive 4500 mAh battery which uses a 25W super fast charger. In my battery drain test, it took 8 hours and 28 minutes for its battery to go from 100 to 0. It took only 82 minutes to charge the battery from 0 all the way up to 100. I have also published the battery drain on my channel and you can look at that for better understanding. In my opinion, this is a very impressive battery output. For the security, the Note 10 Lite uses an optical in-display fingerprint reader which works fine, no problems there at all. It also has the Face ID unlock. Comparing the Note 10 Lite to the Galaxy S10 Lite, while you get an S Pen and the headphone jack on the Note 10 Lite with few compromises on its performance, the S10 Lite brings a better camera, better performance, but of course no S Pen and no headphone jack there. Both phones compromise on something and I find the Note 10 Lite with more compromises. Both phones are equally big and both are slightly overpriced. This brings us to the conclusion of this review. Do I recommend the Galaxy Note 10 Lite? Well, no. It's not worth all that money. Some of you may find it good, but I am not all praises for this phone, and the reason is the price bracket. This is literally a Galaxy Note 9 with a new form factor and design. Its internals still remain the same old, including its camera system. If these downsides are not a big deal for you, pick it up, and you may or may not regret it. That is my personal take on the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Lite. Rest is going to be your own choice. Drop your feedback about this review in the comments below. Subscribe if you have not yet. With that said, I will sign off. See you in the next one.